Imagine you've been thrown into a new website project. And for this project, you're going to need to make a button. And for this button, you'll need three variations: primary, secondary, and tertiary. Now you'll need to multiply that by 11, because you've been tasked with building an entire suite of websites. And of course, in such a tight time frame, because that's how it goes, right? That single button, now copied and pasted to all 11 website repositories, has a new requirement of including an icon. So the development team splits up and adds the icon to each instance of this button. So far, so good. But then suddenly one of the team members is distracted by something. Could be the door, could be an emergency. Regardless, they miss a site. But imagine that this mistake was caught and it's all taken care of. Your client's thrilled. So thrilled that they put out a PCR to include a 12th website. The copying and pasting will never end. Studies show that manual copying and pasting and fixing errors can lead to a 15% increase of project development time. For a small agency like ours, that's not just an abstract number. It translates to weeks worth of lost productivity and almost 60 cups of coffee per week. And trust me, we'd rather spend those weeks on more essential things than staring at our screens, fueled by a never-ending supply of caffeine, desperately trying to fix component inconsistencies across the websites. There must be a better solution than copying and pasting, leaving room for human error.
Thank you. Well, luckily, you have me. Hi, I'm Mel, and I'm the lead developer for Hide and Seek Digital. We're a small agency based in Australia and New Zealand, but our clients and even team spans globally. We're all about building simple solutions for complex problems that'll last through time. In my role at the company, I guide a dynamic team of talented individuals through the ever-evolving software development landscape. And this landscape is always developing and must be checked upon on the regular. By the time this talk concludes, three new JavaScript libraries will have likely emerged into the technical world. The situation I explained in dramatic detail was recently a complex problem that we'd faced. And personally, I'd aim to establish components correctly from the outset and iterate upon them, rather than repeatedly duplicating components while hoping to avoid the need for extensive and tedious adjustments each time that someone requested a new feature. This approach aimed to save both time and effort for our team.
Our journey began with Storybook, a versatile front-end tool that fosters design consistency across numerous components. It allowed our developers to work with each component in isolation, following the atomic design methodology as they built from atoms to molecules and beyond. Storybook also facilitated collaboration with designers by enabling us to send working components for review before integrating them into our sites. As our projects grew, we needed an efficient way to manage content across multiple websites. Enter Storybook, our chosen headless CMS. Its simple REST API allowed us to structure each site as a folder. By specifying the folder name, we effortlessly received the correct website data. This approach also enabled us to create a shared folder for common information, such as terms and conditions. This then eliminated the need for redundant data copying. But the real game changer was Next.js. With a full storybook of components at our disposal, we sought a unified solution to manage all of our websites without the headaches of replicating code across 11 repositories. By harnessing the power of Next.js and using environmental variables, we could load only the necessary website data, ensuring that relevant styles, fonts, and assets were loaded instead of trying to hide 11 websites worth of data in a single instance. Integrating our storybook components seamlessly into Next.js also provided us with TypeScript information, ensuring data consistency and adherence to our standards. Additionally, reusable functions from our storybook found their place in Next.js, enhancing code consistency. Next.js's server-side rendering and static site generation capabilities allowed us to optimize performance. For instance, we could statically generate less frequently updated content, such as terms and conditions, granting them longer cache lives than dynamic elements, such as products. We could do both at the same time. The versatility of Next.js extended to unique redirects for each site, managed through middleware. By utilizing environment variables, we could isolate redirects to specific websites, offering content authors the flexibility to create, modify, and remove redirects on the fly, while also enabling shared redirects. Next.js's proficient handling of URL rewrites ensured a clean user experience despite the complex routing structures. It became the powerhouse solution that brought everything together seamlessly. Our sites also require the ability for multilingual pages, a crucial feature in our global digital projects. With Next.js, we seamlessly integrated internationalization support, allowing us to serve content in multiple languages. This feature, combined with the power of Storybook, made managing translations a breeze. We maintained a clear separation of concerns by handling the translations separately in Storybook. This approach allowed content authors to manage translations without directly interacting with the code base. Through the use of Storybook's internationalization features and Next.js's routing capabilities, we achieved a smooth user experience for visitors all across the globe. To top it off, we could now deploy new components and updates to all 11 websites with a simple click and a GitHub deployment action. This streamlined approach effectively consolidated our 11 websites into just two repositories. In summary, our journey led us from Storybook to Storybook, and then finally, Next.js, a robust solution that transformed our web development arsenal. Each step addressed specific challenges, accumulating in a streamlined, efficient, and future-proof process for managing multiple websites. All maintained in two repositories, one for Next.js and one for Storybook. If we wanted to, we could have made this a single repository. But for the future of the project, we wanted to have the ability to share these components with other systems for the client. At the end of the day, two repositories is just easier than 11. With Next.js, we achieved the ultimate goal of being able to use only two instances to manage all 11 websites, eliminating the need for replicating code across numerous repositories. This in turn streamlined our development process and made it more manageable. If required, we could have each website on its own branch to lock down the component library versions per site. We've not yet had to do this because as part of our build process, we've included robust testing against all the websites using Cypress. In the grand tapestry of web development, our journey through these challenges and innovative solutions is nearing its conclusion. The combination of Storybook, Storybook, and Next.js have been the driving force behind the success of our project. These tools have allowed us to build a robust and efficient system for managing multiple websites, and a few aspects deserve a little bit more highlighting. One of the remarkable advantages of our setup is the ease of which we can send updates to all 11 websites. With just a click of the button and a magic GitHub deployment action, we can propagate changes effortlessly. This means that our 11 websites are not isolated entities, but are a part of a digital ecosystem. This streamlined approach saves time and ensures consistency across all of the projects. While the possibility of consolidating everything into a single repository was considered, we deliberately chose to keep this only as two. This decision was made with an eye towards the future, where we anticipate the need to share components with other systems of our client. This forward-thinking approach ensures that our system remains adaptable and responsive to evolving project requirements. Furthermore, if needed, the flexibility to maintain separate branches for each website ensures that we can lock down component library versions per site. This level of control enhances our ability to manage changes and updates, catering to the specific needs of each site. In closing, the marriage of Storybook, Storybook, and Next.js have not only solved the challenges we face, but have also paved the way for scalable, efficient, and future-proof web development. The collaborative effort of our team and the power of these tools have transformed our project management and development approach. And as we reflect on this journey, it's clear that the icing on the cake has always been the integration of Next.js. It has empowered us to manage multiple websites effortlessly, ushering in an era of efficiency, consistency, and adaptability. With Next.js at the helm, our web development arsenal is stronger than ever, ready to tackle any challenges that the digital landscape may present. In the world of development, there are countless ways to approach a task, each with its level of complexity. It's a testament to the ever-evolving nature of our field. So thank you for joining me on this exploration of our complex project and the innovative solutions that we implemented. If you want to check out some more of the projects we've done at Hide and Seek Digital, we have a pretty rad website at www.hideandseek.digital, showcasing the unique humans and the work of the company. And bonus points if you can find all the Easter eggs. If you want to follow me, I'm on GitHub and LinkedIn, and I'd love to have a virtual coffee to chat all things tech.